Hello, Valor. As we're getting close to that time of year where you pick your courses for next year, we want to take a few minutes to go through what your options are through our virtual Valor High School course fair. The first thing that you need to think about is, what do I have to take? What does my next year look like with the courses that are compulsory or mandatory and the courses that I get to choose or your electives? So this chart goes through very quickly what high school looks like for each grade. So you've gone through grade 9, where you've had almost no choice and all of your courses have been mandatory. Those of you who are going into grade 10 next year, notice that you get a little bit more choice. You still have to take English, math, science, history, and careers in civics, but that leaves you space for 3 electives. In grade 11, you have even more choice. The 2 mandatory courses are English and math, and that leaves you room for 6 elective courses. Finally, in grade 12, the mandatory course is English, but there are 2 asterisks on the chart because that's an indication that most of you should think about picking a math course for next year. It's not required to graduate, but a lot of programs at post-secondary require you to have a grade 12 math. So that's something to think about if you're picking your grade 12 courses. Beyond that, you then have 6 or 7 choices for electives for grade 12. And just remember, in order to graduate from Ontario and earn your diploma, you need to make sure you have 30 credits by the end of grade 12. So what are all those other choices that are available? What are those courses that you can take as electives next year? We're going to go through by each department and show you what the options are for next year at Valor. The first department that we're going to visit is the arts. Just like the quote says, art subjects encourage self-expression and creativity and can build confidence as well as a sense of individual identity. Studying art subjects also help to develop a critical thinking and the ability to interpret the world around us. All of the art courses at Valor place emphasis on the creation or performance of the art form, the corresponding theory and the background to build a stronger foundation, and the critical analysis of the art form at various levels. In the arts, your first choice is music. And as Mrs. Catlin says, music is life. You have 4 choices at Valor for music courses: the grade 9 and the grade 10 open courses, and then the grade 11 and grade 12 university and college level courses. For visual arts, you can graduate with 5 visual arts courses if you choose. In grade 9, you would have taken the Exploring Indigenous, Métis, Inuit, and First Nations Cultures course. This was your first experience with Art of Valor. In grade 10, there is 1 visual arts course for you to choose. This gives you the chance to experiment and create with all different types of media. Once you get to grade 11, visual art splits into 2 streams. You can take AVI 301 or AVI 3M1, the open or mixed college and university course that allows you to create with all different types of media. If drawing and painting is more your speed, then you can take the AWM 3M1 drawing and painting course. The grade 12 options are very similar, with the AVI 4M1 course allowing you to create with all different media as you did in grade 11, and the AWM 4M1, the drawing and painting course that follows the grade 11 course. Next is drama. Next year, Valor will have 4 offerings of drama, 1 for each grade. In addition to the grade 9 and 10 introductory drama courses, you can now take a drama at the university and college level in both grade 11 and 12. To complete your drama journey throughout high school. But what might you do in drama class? Mrs. Horton, this year's drama teacher, has said drama is made up of 3 parts. It's individual study, mindfulness, movement and voice recognition, and monologues. Then it's understanding theater, theater history, elements of drama, styles of theaters, and theater across cultures. And finally, it's also group and partner activities, such as warm-up games, improv games, scene building, and performing. The last stop in the arts department are the 2 photography courses. Each year, Mr. Schroeder teaches photography at both the grade 11 and grade 12 university and college levels. This is your chance to learn how to take pictures and present your work for different audiences. The next department we're going to look at is the Canadian and World Studies Department. Here, you'll find two different types of courses for you to choose next year. First are the two law courses. Mr. Scott has put together his top 10 reasons to take law in either grade 11 or grade 12. Number one, interesting discussions. Number two, mock trials. Number three, it's not math or science. Sorry, Miss Jen and Miss Graham. Four, it opens up more than just a police or lawyer career path. Five, it challenges the way you look at Canada and the world. Six, guest speakers, including an OPP detective. Seven, different opinions on world events. Eight, it's where all the cool students are. Nine, it makes you a more informed Canadian. And 10, you gain real-world knowledge and skills. The other course that's available next year in the Canadian and World Studies Department is CHW 3M1, or World History to the 16th Century. This is a university and college level course that explores the history of various societies and civilizations from around the world, from the earliest times to about 1500 CE. The third stop in our tour of Valor departments is the English department. You saw in the chart earlier that you do have to take an English course every year in order to graduate. However, there are two optional English courses that you can take as your electives. First is the Media Studies course. This is a grade 11 open course, and it emphasizes the knowledge and skills that enable students to understand and create various types of media communications in the 21st century. For grade 12 students, if you're interested in literature, there is a new course at Valor next year at the college and university level called Studies in Literature. This is a course for students with a special interest in literature and literary criticism, and it may focus on a specific theme, genre, time period, or country in the literature pieces that the teacher chooses. Now, we say bonjour to our Valor French department. This year, it's Madame Bergevin and Madame Brunet. You had to take French in grade 9, but why should you continue French in grade 10, 11, and even 12? You have more opportunities for jobs and more money. It's good for the brain. It gives you the opportunity to travel, meet new people, explore new cultures. You can have fun, learn other languages and other skills, and even improve your own first language. For those of you who are in the core French program, you have the choice to take a language course each year in high school. In grade 10, you can take either academic or applied French. And in grade 11 and grade 12, you take French at the university level. If you are a French immersion student and you're in grade 10, to continue the program for the next year, you'll be taking three courses: your French language course, and then two subject courses in French, geography and technological design. For grade 11 and grade 12 French immersion students, you'll take your grade 11 or 12 French course at the appropriate grade level, and then you'll take a content area course in world cultures. Just remember, for those of you in either the core French or the French immersion program, if you complete the courses all the way through to grade 12, you can challenge the DELF exam at the end of grade 12 that will certify your French language to an international standard of French. You can take this all over the world to study, for jobs, or anywhere else that you want to show how you can speak French. If you complete four courses in core French or all 10 courses in French immersion, you also receive a certificate at graduation from the Renfrew County District School Board that shows your achievement in French throughout high school. And now, Madame Brunet is going to explain a little bit more about the New World Cultures course, and this time, a first bilingual course that we've ever offered at Valor.
Hi, Voyagers. Madame Brunet here to talk to you about the World Cultures course, which is being offered for the first time here at Valor. The code is HSC4M or HSC4MF. And I want to talk to you specifically about that because it's the first time that we're trying to do a bilingual course. So this course, the content will be the same whether you take it in English or French. But of course, those students who are looking to get an extra French credit to practice that, if you're in French immersion, you can choose to take it in French and everyone else can choose to take it in English. What's really cool about this course is that it looks at cultures, cultural identities, how cultures are formed, how they're transformed in both Canada and around the world. So we'll be looking at arts, you know, music, visual arts, all kinds of arts, religion, philosophy, food. We hope to try some foods from around the world. History, geography, language, like all elements of culture. And what will be slightly different is, as I say, it's bilingual. So we'll be doing stuff together. Lessons will be kind of run English and French. If you've been in my core classes before, you know that I can switch between the two languages. And French immersion students will be grouped together, so they'll do their discussions in French, they'll submit their work in French, they'll be evaluated in French. When they're talking with me and with each other, they're talking in French. And if you're taking it in English, you'll hear some French, which is great in a culture class, but you'll be able to do your projects in English, you'll be interacting with me in English, small group work in English. So it's kind of a new concept, but I think it's gonna work really, really well for this course, and I'm excited to see all the people that could sign up and how this is gonna work. But I'm really looking forward to this, and I think it's a great opportunity to learn some cool stuff and to do it in the language that you wanna do that in. Okay, if you have any questions, I'm in room 246. I'm happy to talk about it and have yourselves a great course selection season. Bye guys, au revoir.
So, as you heard Madame Brunet say, if you have any questions about either the core or French immersion programs or the new World Cultures course being offered for the first time bilingually, you can stop by and see her in room 246 or send her an email. And if you don't believe Madame Brunet or myself, listen to Buddy the Elf. J'aime parler français. Le français est ma préférée. Now, let's head into the gym to see what's happening in the phys ed, or Healthy Active Living Education Department.
My name is Mr. Schroeder.
My name is Mrs. Pinkerton.
And I'm Mrs. Stevenson, and welcome to the phys ed department.
Woo!
You already remember us from movies like Raiders of the Lost Ark,
Rambo,
or Rudy.
Woo!
My favorite sport is, obviously, track and field and cross country.
Volleyball would be my favorite sport.
And I love basketball.
Stick around, and we'll tell you a little bit about what we have to offer here in the gym.
Woo!
Woo!
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. Touch this. My
this. Music hits me so hard, makes me say, oh my Lord, thank you for blessing me. When a mind too round and too hyped, it feels good when you know you're down. A super dope homeboy from the Oak Town, and I'm known as such, and this is the up you can't touch. I told you, homeboy, you can't touch this. Yeah, that's how we living, and you know you can't touch this. Look in my eyes, man. Touch this. Yo, let me bust the funky lyrics. Touch this. Fresh new kicks and bands. You got it like that. Now you know you wanna dance. So move out of your seat and get a fire going and catch this beat while it's rolling. Hold on, pump a little bit and let the noise go on like that. Like that. Pull on a mix of the ball on back. Let them know that you're too much. And this is a beat they can't touch. Yo, I told you, you can't touch this. Why you standing there, man? Can't touch this. Yo, sound the bell. School is in, sucker. Can't touch this. Give me a song, a rhythm, making them sweat. That's what I'm giving them now. They know. You're talking about the hammer. You're talking about a show that's hype and tight. Singles are sweating so fast, I'm a whiteboard tape. To learn what it's gonna take in the 90s to burn the charts. Legit. Either work hard or you might as well quit. That word, because you know. You can't touch
this. You can't touch this.
Okay.
Break it down. Stop. Hammer time. Go with the flow. It is said if you can't do the list, you probably are dead. So wave your hands in the air. Bust a few moves. Run your fingers through your hair. This is it. For a winner. Dance to this, and you're gonna get better. The move. Slide your rump. Just for a minute. Let's all do the bump.
Okay.
Yeah. Can't touch this. Can't touch this. You better get a hype, boy, cause you know you can't touch this. Ring the bell, school's back in. Break it down. Stop. Have a time. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. Break it down. Stop. Have a time.
So today I'm going to talk to you about the PPL courses. Those are the ones that you want to pick if you want to play sports. So basketball, volleyball, badminton, all of those sports are the ones in the PPL class. Okay?
Okay. High pro is not about being a good athlete. High pro is about being the best athlete that you can be. If you don't want to run, if you want to do circus and work hard and sweat, high pro may not be for you. But if you do, if you want to become a great athlete and go through 4 years of in the best physical condition you can be, topping it off with a PLS course in leadership, high pro is a course for you.
Hi everyone, I'm going to talk about the fitness course, the PAF. This is for grades 10, 11, and 12. If you like to do a lot of fitness workouts, like to go into the weight room, this is the course for you. We really do a lot of teacher-led workouts. We do Tabatas and HIIT workouts. It's a great course, so hopefully you'll be interested.
Hi Fowler, I'm here today to talk about our Sports Shazam. That's our specialist fine skills major course here at Valor. If you have an interest in sports, being physically active, being fit, training, if you're interested in biology, if you're interested in doing a co-op in the sports field, then Sports Shazam is something that would interest you. We do lots of field trips, training and techniques, wrapping and taping, downhill skiing, fitness classes, GPS, and of course, first aid and CPR. So give it a try.
So just to recap, those course choices for phys ed next year, if you are interested in the sport-focused PPL courses, these are PPL 201, 301, and 401. If you're more interested in the personal fitness courses, these are the PAF courses, PAF 201, 301, and 401. And if you're in the high-performance sports program, you're picking two courses per year, PAF 20H, PAI 20H for grade 10, PAF 30H, and PAI 30H for grade 11, and then finally for grade 12, PAF 40H and the leadership course, PLF 4MH. But wait, there's one new thing happening in phys ed next year. This is a new course that we're going to try called Individual and Small Group Activities. This is a self-focused course. This is for those of you who maybe aren't interested in the real heavy fitness workouts, or who maybe aren't interested in doing team sports like basketball or volleyball. You want to focus more on individual activities that are going to help you maintain a healthy lifestyle. These courses will run in grade 10 and 11 next year, and the course codes are PAI201 and PAI301. Now, let's head upstairs to see what's happening in the math and science departments. Just as a reminder from earlier in the course fair presentation, in order to earn your diploma, you need 3 credits in math, at least one of those has to be in grade 11 or in grade 12, and you need 2 credits in science. So why do you want to take math? Remember, it's a way to understand the world, become a problem solver, develop transferable skills, and it's a fun and great way to challenge yourself. This year, in grade 9, most of you took the D-Stream math course, MTH1W1, while some of you took the locally developed MAT1L1 class. Next year, for grade 10, you're going to have to choose a course based on the post-secondary pathway you think you're most likely to follow after high school. For those of you looking to head to university, the Principle of Mathematics MPM 2D1 academic course is your course. MFM 2P1 is for those of you looking at college and is the Foundations of Mathematics course. And for those of you who are continuing in the locally developed pathway in grade 10, you'll be taking MAT 2L1. In grade 11, there's actually 4 pathways you can follow. For those of you staying in the locally developed or workplace pathway, MEL 3E1, Math for Work and Everyday Life, is your choice. If you were in the applied pathway in grade 10, you can choose to continue on to the college math course, MBF 3C1, which will give you the foundations for the math that you'll take in college. Or you can choose a bit more theory, and the Functions and Applications course, MCF 3M1, would be the best choice for you. For those of you who took academic math in grade 10, you have 2 choices as well. If you're not heading on to a math-based post-secondary program, or if you want a good mix of theory and practical examples, the MCF 3M1 Functions and Application course is for you. For those of you looking at math or science or engineering pathways after high school, the MCR 3U1 Functions course leads you to the courses you will need in grade 12. For those of you entering grade 12, the choices are even bigger. Again, for those of you following the locally developed or workplace pathway, MEL 4E1, the Math for Work and Everyday Life course, is your choice. Most of you who are heading to college would look at the MAP 4C1 option. This is the Foundations for College Math that follows on from the grade 11 course. If you are heading for a very technical college field, you might need the MCT 4C1, Math for College Technology program. But be aware of 2 things. Number 1, it's only offered via an e-learning course. And number 2, you have to have taken the grade 11 Functions and Applications, or MCF 3M1 course, to move forward into this pathway. For those of you heading to university in fields like psychology or other places where a good basis in statistics is a need, or for those of you who are not strong in math and looking to head into nursing, Data Management Math MDM 4U1 gives you that 1 4U math credit that you need to apply to post-secondary. And for those of you who are heading on into the science, math, or engineering fields, you would need MHF 4U1, Advanced Functions in first semester, and then Calculus and Vectors, MCV 4U1 in semester 2. So what about all those rooms down the second floor blue hallway at Valor? What's happening in the science department, and why would you want to take science? Science generates solutions for everyday life. You learn problem solving and critical thinking skills. You develop transferable skills, and it is fun and challenging. For those of you in grade 9, this year you had the choice of applied, academic, or locally developed science, but for next year, science will be de-streamed as well, so there's the choice of science de-streamed or a locally developed science. Then in grade 10, you pick your pathway based on your post-secondary destination. Academic science, SNC 2D1, leads to those university-level science courses and a university pathway. Science 2P1, your applied science, leads to courses at college. And the locally developed science, SNC 2L1, leads to workplace pathways. After grade 10, science isn't a compulsory course anymore. You can earn your Group 3 credit by taking a grade 11 or grade 12 course, but most people take grade 11 and grade 12 science based on what they want to do after high school. If you are heading to college, the grade 11 course you can take is the biology course, SBI 3C1. For those of you heading on a university pathway, you'll have science courses in both grade 11 and grade 12. Biology, SBI 3U1, chemistry, SCH 3U1, and physics, SPH 3U1, are all available for students at Valor. In grade 12, the course offerings are a little bit more diverse. You can continue in the university pathway or the college pathway based on where you're heading after high school. If you're in the college pathway, chemistry, SCH 4C1, and physics, SPH 4C1, are your courses. For those of you in the university pathway, biology, SBI 4U1, chemistry, SCH 4U1, and physics, SPH 4U1, are your courses. If you're heading to either university or college and have a specific interest in human biology or healthcare science, we do have the SNC 4M1 course that focuses on just those topics. And just remember, the top four skill areas that experts say people need to succeed in the 21st century are critical thinking and problem solving, communication, collaboration, creativity and innovation, and you'll find all four of those in math and science courses at Valor.
Welcome to room 190, where all the cooking magic happens. This is the kitchen at Valor School.
Here in the kitchen, we have three courses that run pretty much every year. The grade 10 foods and nutrition course, which is a basics class of all the different things that you might need to know in the long term. We have the foods and culture class for grade 11. In grade 11, you take a look at the world and how food has inspired Canadians to reach outside the box. And then in grade 12, we have a two-layer, either a grade 12 university or a grade 12 college credit that looks at the different science and geography background in food, and it is called nutrition and health. Typically these run once or twice every year and are available to all students. Regardless of whether you have taken a foods class before or not, we'd love to see you come to the kitchen. The other courses that sometimes will happen in here are the parenting class and the personal life management class, which is also known as the adulting class. If you are interested in those, then you'd be looking at learning about how to raise healthy children. We do taking home the babies. We do learning about what kinds of things to expect as a parent and whether or not you're ready to dive into that lifestyle. And in personal life management, we take a look at things like how to buy a house, how to rent a car, how to rent a house, how to do your taxes. There's lots of different things to learn in those classes. And if you're interested in either of those as you look through your course selection and you have questions, please let me know. Good luck with your course selections, and I hope we'll see you next year.
So just like you heard Mrs. Arsenault say, Room 190 at Valor is where you'll find most of the social science courses happening. Every year, there are three options for students who are interested in foods courses. The grade 10 food and nutrition course is HFN 201. Grade 11 foods and culture course is HFC 3M1. And then for grade 12, the nutrition and health course can either be taken at the college level, HFA 4C1, or at the university level, HFA 4U1. In alternate years, like this year, you'll find the HPC 301, or Raising Healthy Children course, which means for next year, when you pick your courses, you will see the grade 12 personal life management course, or as Mrs. Arsenault said, the adulting course, HIP 401 available. There is one other course that we offer in the social sciences at Valor every year. And I've heard this is called the Trilogy course, but is most commonly known as Introduction to Anthropology, Psychology, and Sociology, HSP 301 at the university level, or HSP 3C1 at the college level. In this course, you'll learn three different things. First of all, what's anthropology? Anthropology is the scientific study of humanity, and it's concerned with human behavior, biology, culture, societies, and linguistics. Psychology is a scientific study of the mind and behavior. And sociology is a social science that focuses on society, human social behavior, patterns of social relationships, social interaction, and aspects of culture associated with everyday life. So when you put those three definitions from Wikipedia together, this is what you learn in that course. The final department at Valor that offers courses for students in grade 10, 11, and 12 is the technology department. Here you'll find Mr. Lair, Mr. Keel, and Mr. LeClaire offering courses to students in six different areas. First of all, if you head upstairs to the computer lab, you're going to find three different options. First is communication technology. These are the TGJ courses taken at the open level in grade 10 or the college university level in grade 11 or 12. These courses focus on the areas of TV, video and movie production, radio and audio production, print and graphic communications, photography, digital imaging, broadcast journalism, and interactive new media and animation. A new option for next year is a technological design course. This is available again at the open level in grade 10 or at the college university level in grade 11 and grade 12. These are the TDJ courses. These courses provide students with a variety of learning experiences that focus on the practical application of the principles of engineering, architecture, and design. Finally, in the computer lab, you'll find our computer engineering, or as they're more commonly known, the robotics courses at grade 11 and grade 12 at the university and college level. These are the TEJ courses. These courses include the related areas of computer hardware and software, computer interfacing, programming and networking, analog and digital electronics, and robotics. If you head down to the wood shop, you're going to find Mr. Keel teaching two different types of courses. First are the construction technology, or TCJ courses. These courses are offered at the open level in grade 10 or the college level in grade 11 and grade 12. In these courses, students will learn about designing, constructing, and maintaining a variety of buildings and structures and will gain experience with the tools, equipment, and processes commonly used in the field. If you're more interested in custom woodworking, you can look at the TWJ courses in grade 11 and grade 12. Both of these courses are offered at the workplace level, and they enable students to develop knowledge and skills related to cabinet making and furniture making by using a variety of materials, tools, equipment, and joinery techniques. Finally, if you look for Mr. Lair, you'll find him in the auto shop teaching two different types of courses as well. First are the TMJ courses, or manufacturing technology courses, again offered at the open level in grade 10 and the workplace level in grade 11 or grade 12. Students will develop skills and knowledge in design and fabrication, as well as using tools and equipment such as engine lathes, milling machines, and welding machines. And finally, the transportation tech, or TTJ courses, again offered at the grade 10 open and grade 11 and grade 12 college levels. These courses enable students to study both vehicle ownership and vehicle maintenance, and to develop skills and prepare for careers in the servicing and the repairs of vehicles. Even though room 172 is the home of our cooperative education program at Valor, if you stop by, you won't often see very many students in the room. That's because co-op gives students in grade 11 and grade 12 a chance to earn credits by actually going to work instead of being in class. Co-op is a career study course that allows students to evaluate their future. It's a key to helping students decide what career field they wish to go to once they graduate. Co-op gives students valuable insight into their future careers. It'll tell you what the job entails that you might be considering and what to expect if you pursue that career field. It will give you personal opinions about the jobs, assess your skills and strengths, and give you an understanding of how that job operates. It gives you hands-on experience, and it gives you an understanding of what is necessary as an employee in that career field. It helps you start to develop the skills and knowledge needed for that job, and it gives you experience in the field. If you are thinking about co-op in general, we're looking for students in grade 11 or grade 12 who are well on the way to completing their compulsory credits, and they have recommendations from a teacher or from an employer that they would like to work with. You also should have a desire to pursue a similar career so that you're getting the most out of your co-op experience. If you are choosing co-op, you have three different options. You can take a one-credit co-op where you spend one period working at a placement. A two-credit co-op allows you to spend half a day at your placement, and usually this is somewhere outside of the school. Finally, a four-credit co-op is usually reserved for grade 12 students who have completed all of their compulsory credits, because this means they spend four periods or the entire day at a workplace and only come to school for specific integration activities. One of our co-op students in grade 12 this year, Jaslyn Abbott, had the following to say about what she feels the benefits of taking cooperative education are. Cooperative education offers a unique opportunity for students to build real-world skills and explore their potential career options. As important as in-class learning is, experience in the workforce is invaluable to youth. These placements allow high school students to develop connections with coworkers, experience responsibilities different from regular education, and often receive job offers from their workplace. Well, this isn't a course you have to pick. It is something available to students in grade 11 and grade 12 at Valor, and that's the Specialist High Skills Major, or SHZAM, program. SHZAM is a program for students who are taking four courses and a co-op placement in a specific area in grade 11 and 12. Once you're identified as having those courses and you join the SHZAM program, you're provided with opportunities to enhance your learning with activities such as certifications, guest speakers, special events, and/or field trips. The really neat part about SHZAM is that everything you do is provided to you at no cost or completely for free. At Valor, we have four different sectors in SHZAM that are available. Mrs. Neville coordinates the arts and culture sector. Mr. LeClaire coordinates the information and communications technology sector. Mrs. Pinkerton coordinates sports, and Mr. Lair coordinates the transportation group. But what do I get with SHZAM? Why is it important? Why would I want to do this? And it's what you get at graduation, plus it's all the skills that you've earned throughout the program. At graduation, if you successfully complete the SHZAM program, you will actually get a special Ontario Secondary School diploma with a red seal. This is the only type of specialized diploma you can get in high school. It shows that you've had a major in a specific area during high school. You get to wear a fancy red cord around your neck with your graduation gown, and you also receive a specialist high skills major record with your transcript that shows all of the courses and all of the extra things that you've done during high school in that area, which is a great resume builder or something you can use for scholarships or awards. Finally, one other option available to students in grade 11 or 12 are the Renfrew County District School Board e-learning courses. These are courses taught by teachers in a Renfrew County District School Board school that are done and delivered completely online. While they're not for all students, and you probably by now have a good idea if you learn well online or not, they do expand the course offerings that you have available to you at Valor. The courses that are offered include business studies such as accounting and marketing, courses in geography such as travel and tourism or environment and resource management, Canadian history or world history since the 16th century courses, courses in computer programming and computer science, an introductory kinesiology course, environmental or earth and space science, and social science courses such as understanding fashion, families in Canada, or philosophy. You choose these courses like you would choose a regular course, but just understand that they are completely online, done at your own pace, with the support of a teacher in a different school. So what happens next? You've listened to the course fair, you've maybe made some decisions, or maybe you still have no idea. Here's what the next couple of weeks look like. You've already received an email from me with the information about course selection for this year. It's got the schedule of the dates and a sample course selection form outlining all the different opportunities that we've looked at today that you have to choose from next year. Please make sure you check that before you come to pick your courses. If you are in grade 9, you will choose your courses on either February 8th, 9th, or 10th. Grade 10s will be picking their courses on February 14th, 17th, 18th, and 22nd. Grade 11s will be choosing on February 23rd, 24th, 25th, and 28th. And any grade 12 coming back for a fifth year will be choosing their courses on March 1st and 2nd. When it's your turn to pick your courses, you'll be called down to guidance. Please bring a pencil or pen with you to help fill in the course selection form. If you do miss your date, you'll be added to a catch-up day either at the end of your grade or at the end of the course selection period after everyone has chosen. It doesn't impact your choices in any way. It's just a way for me to keep track of which students still need to pick their courses for each grade. If you are a remote learning student this year, you'll be doing your course selection online and you have a specific date indicated on the schedule. Once you've picked your courses, we will send a copy home to you and your parents for a final confirmation that these are the courses you want to take in 2022-2023. Thank you very much for being part of our virtual course fair this year. And as always, if you have any questions, please stop by to see me in guidance at any time. Have a great rest of your day.